How to apply for your Canadian work permit and Canadian work visa in 10 days from outside of Canada. That's what you're going to be talking about in today's video. Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm so glad that you are watching. If you're new here, welcome, karibu. My name is Eva Mtali, and on this channel, we talk about all things travel, we talk about visa, we talk about work permits, permanent residences, and all that. So if any of those topics sound exciting to you, you want to hit the subscribe button below. And once you have done so, you want to hit the notification bell as well, so that every single time I shoot a new video, you do not miss out. Without much further ado, the first step in getting your work visa, your work permit for Canada, processed in 10 days or less, that is in 2 weeks, you have to confirm your eligibility. So technically, for you to get your Canadian work permit and work visa processed from outside of Canada in 2 weeks, that is in 10 days, you have to go through what they call the Global Talent Stream or the GTS. So the Global Talent Stream or the GTS in Canada is technically a program under the Global Skills Program where the Canadian employers are allowed to expedite processing of work permits for workers or foreign workers outside of Canada, and this is usually done in 2 weeks. The GTS program is to ensure that Canadian employers can fill up vacancies in Canada whereby they have been unable to find qualified permanent residents or Canadian nationals that can fill them. Hence, they open up these applications to people living outside of Canada. So you want to make sure, first of all, that you qualify to make your application through the GTS program. So technically, your application through the GTS program will not be done by yourself. It can only be done by your Canadian employer, but they will have to include you in the application. So in reality, you don't have to do the application by yourself. Your potential employer will make that application for you. There are special skill sets that qualify under the Global Talent Stream, under the GTS, and that's why you need to make sure that you have advanced knowledge in that area. And this could be in the form of having at least 5 years of work experience in that area, or you have an advanced education or advanced degree in that area. So some of the global talent occupations as at the shooting of this video include computer and information systems managers, computer engineers, mathematicians and statisticians, information system analysts and consultants, database analysts, data administrators, software engineers and designers, computer programmers, interactive media developers, web designers and web developers, computer network technicians, information system technicians, producers, technical, creative and artistic directors, project managers, designer and people who work in media, in audio visuals. I'm also going to leave a link at the bottom where you can find the most up-to-date global occupations list that qualify under the GTS stream. So if you have skill in any of those areas that I have mentioned, wanna check that. So that's the first step, number one. So where do you find job vacancies in Canada for Global Talent Stream application? So there's four that I managed to find out. As usual, make sure you do your due diligence. So the first one is Moving to Canada Jobs Board. Again, I'm gonna leave a link at the bottom. We have the Government of Canada Operated Job Bank Database. And then number three, we have Job Match Canada. And then of course, number four, we have LinkedIn, yeah? So as usual, make sure you do your own due diligence, but these are some of the websites whereby you can start and look for those occupations or those jobs in Canada that are currently hiring foreigners under the Global Talent Stream. So step number two in making sure that your Canadian work visa, work permit, and application is processed in 2 weeks or in 10 days, you have to make sure that you land a valid job offer from a GTS or a Global Talent Stream eligible employer. So your employer has to confirm that they are eligible to hire under the GTS stream. And there are two categories whereby your potential employer could fall under. Category A is what they call a designated partner referral. This is whereby there's a whole host of designated partners who could refer your employer. And again, I'm going to leave a link at the bottom where you can check the most updated list. So they are GTS designated partners, organizations, and they are the ones who would refer your employer. So for your employer to qualify under the category A, they must make sure that the talent which they're hiring for is unique and it's specialized, and they must be paying you at least $80,000 Canadian or higher per year. So that's the qualification. And of course, the job you're being hired under must fall under the global talent occupation list. Category B of potential employers who could hire you under the global talent stream is what they call in-demand occupation, whereby your potential employer must be hiring to fill a position on the global talent list of occupations. And additionally, the position must be paying a salary that is equivalent or above the prevailing wage for that position. Yeah, your employer must confirm eligibility for one of the two streams, either category A or category B. They can submit the applications either online, by mail, or by fax. They must include information about this particular employer. It must include details about you as the foreign worker. It also includes a job offer, including details about your salary and any other benefits. If your potential employer is applying under the GTS stream for the first time, they must submit the labor market benefits plan, which demonstrates how they will benefit the Canadian labor market by hiring you as a foreigner. So if it is a category A employer, they must show that they will increase job creation for Canadians. If it is a category B employer, they must show how they will increase skills and training for Canadians. So in addition to your potential employer showing how they will achieve any two of those, either category A or B, that is creating employment or skills and training investment for Canadians, they must also achieve any two of the following complementary benefits. That's number one, either job creation, investment in skills and training, increase in workplace diversity, knowledge transfer, enhanced company performance, or best company practices and policies. Once they have confirmed that, your employer will then have to pay the GTS or the Global Talent Stream processing fee, which is $1,000 Canadian for every foreign worker that your potential employer will be hiring. They submit their application, and in 10 days or less, your application will come through. So the entire GTS application process by the employer typically takes 10 business days. That's 2 weeks. And if your potential employer's application is successful, then they will receive a positive labor market impact assessment, that is the LMIA, which you will then use to apply for your work permit from outside of Canada. Which leads me to step number three, assuming that your potential employer has gotten a positive LMIA, that is a labor market impact assessment. So you submit your application to the Canadian embassy near you for your work permit and your work visa. So just carry the labor market impact assessment that your employer will have given you, and that's what you're going to use to apply for your Canadian work permit. So the processing time is about 10 business days, that is like 2 weeks. And for you to get a 2 week processing time, or the 10 days processing time for your Canadian work permit and work visa, when you're doing your application, I'm going to leave a link at the bottom, you must answer yes when you're asked if you have a written offer from an employer in Canada. So as you'll be filling in your application, they will ask you, do you have a written offer? You have to fill in and say yes. And then also on the online application for your work permit, you must select a work permit with a labor market impact assessment when asked what type of work permit you are applying for. Lastly, when you're asked if your employer LMIA was issued under the Global Talent Stream, that is the GTS, you must say yes, because applicants applying under the International Mobility Program don't have to answer this as a yes. So you have to be really careful. And I'm going to leave a link at the bottom of where you can apply online for your work permit for Canada, for your work visa for Canada in 2 weeks from outside of Canada. So once your work permit and your work visa application has been approved, you'll be authorized to travel to Canada and start your new position. Well, guys, that's it for today in terms of how you can apply for your Canadian work visa and your Canadian work permit in 10 business days, that is 2 weeks. Let me know in the comment section below if you have any questions, and I'll be happy to answer them. Bye-bye, and I hope to meet you on the next one.